Welcome everyone. I'd like to start off our December video update. We haven't done one in a while since the pandemic and everything going on in the plant with the shutdown. I'd like to just touch on a few topics going on. I'd like to congratulate everyone who ran in the triennial elections back in September. Congratulations to all who was elected. And anybody that wasn't elected, I hope that you stay involved. There's a number of committees out there. You might want to look at joining one of them. But please stay active. We need you going down the road in the future. The annual United Way campaign is going to be a little bit different this year in the plant. Information will be coming out in the next few days with how the program's going to take off, how you can contribute and participate in the program if you do so choose. It's that time of year again when the local is going to do their annual contributions to the community. We picked a few of the local organizations that will make donations out of the negotiated social justice fund that we negotiated. The local, we've instituted the COVID-19 policy here at the Unifor Local 88 Union Hall. It pertains just to the hall, and for everybody that's coming into the hall, you need to provide proof of vaccine. They will be scanned, contact tracing, and ID. This is to meet the requirements of the Ministry of Health in the province of Ontario, and also conform to Unifor National's statement on COVID-19 and participating or entering Unifor properties for meetings or other stuff going on, events. In closing, I just ask that if you're out in the community, please help United Way and Salvation Army. Salvation Army is looking for kettle people to help, so be kind, take care, and be safe.
Hello everyone, welcome to our December video. As Brent stated, it's our first one in a long time. I'm going to go through a bunch of topics, a couple of big ones, the vaccination policy and the bright drop postings are probably the biggest ones that people are asking about. We'll start with production. The company has informed us that we will start running two shifts December 20th and we'll stay that way from January right through to April. Of course, that's very tentative. There's lots of issues going on with parts throughout the world with the microchips and everything else. So hopefully we stay two shifts right through the end of April until we go into the retooling. I want to talk about the vaccination policy. We have been working on this for the past 2 months. We were actually able to make quite a few changes to the policy. As of about 1.5 hours ago, we made some significant changes and gains that you need to follow and understand. If you completed the survey originally, fully vaccinated, you have nothing to worry about. So that takes care of about 90-something percent of the people. But for the rest of the people, I just want to go through everything and please pay attention to it right till the end. If you've had your first vaccine, you will be allowed to continue to work on Monday. You will need to be able to prove you've had your first shot, and you are going to have to show that you had you're fully vaccinated when that occurs. But right now, you will be able to return to work on Monday, but please wait till the end of this for your instructions. If you put in for religious or medical exemption, and it is approved, you will also be allowed to continue to work. From my understanding, they are being very reasonable regarding the exemption requests, and people should start hearing back from those requests by today, and they're hoping to have them all back by tonight. So by supper time, hopefully you've heard. As long as you put it in before noon today, you probably will have an answer, and it sounds like they're being quite flexible on the exemptions. But again, wait to the end for the instructions. If you're pregnant or are breastfeeding, this will be treated as an exemption, and from my understanding, they're going to be very reasonable with those requests and allow all of them. And you can continue to keep working as well on Monday, but again, wait till the end for the instructions. If you did not select fully vaccinated, which about 200 people didn't, you were sent out a letter this past week. Either that, or you got called at home by the company in case you're laid off on on B shift. So we had about 200 members out there, basically the ones I just talked about above. So we have made gains, but now it's up to you. If you received a letter or a phone call, or you're sitting home and you notice you missed a phone call from Cammie, you need to complete your end of it now. So you must call Jackie McPherson, and we'll have her email on the video at the end of the video. You must email Jackie McPherson by noon tomorrow. So noon Friday, you must answer Jackie. All you have to tell her is whether you've had your first vaccination or not. She doesn't need to know a lot of information, just say yes or no, and the date, that's it. If you're looking for an exemption, just text her, make sure she understands that you have put an exemption in, If you already have, just wait. If you have not heard from her by, I'll say, supper time, then make sure you send an exemption or make sure you contact her to find out what's going on. Same if you're pregnant or breastfeeding and you're looking for an exemption, make sure you contact her if you have not heard from her and you've already put one in. But if you have not heard from her by supper time, make sure you put one in. At noon tomorrow, Friday noon, they are going to shut your card off if she has not had any contact with you. For the people, for that group, there's one more group as well. For the members who have asked for an exemption based on a new plant-based vaccine that has not yet hit the market, I do not have an answer. We do have a few people in that group. As of 11 o'clock this morning, which we're filming right now, I do not have an answer for that. We are working on that. Hopefully, they'll give you some latitude for an exemption, but we don't have an answer as of right now. So if you show up on Monday and have done nothing, no vaccine, no survey, no exemption, no plans to do anything, and your card doesn't work, they're going to bring you into the likely the boardroom and going to ask you. If you answer no to every single thing, they're going to send you home immediately and shut off your swipe card, and you will be put on an immediate unpaid LOA. And I'll get more on that. But if you have done something before noon tomorrow and you come to work Monday and your card is shut off, don't panic. Just go probably to the boardroom again. HR ER will be there. If you've had your vaccine, your first one, because maybe you're doing your first one this weekend, maybe you get an exemption on Saturday or Sunday. You just have to go see the health center, show them, and you'll be allowed to continue to work. So we should be real good on our numbers for Monday. I also want to be clear on one more thing. Starting in January, the health center will be doing random spot checks on our people on the floor. So let's say assembly line breaks down for an hour. They could send 4, 5, 10 people to the health center, which is totally within the lines of letter 68, and they will ask you for proof of your double vaccination. If you falsified your answer, you are going to be terminated, and I do not have much of an answer for you in the way of a grievance. So make sure your answers are correct, and if you put vaccinated, make sure you're vaccinated. We have had many, many meetings and arguments about the vaccination policy and about the possible exemptions. We've given GM all kinds of options. For the last couple of years, we have worked together, no issues. We've wore the mask. We've worked side by side. We have not had one possible breakout in our plant yet. It is not the union that put this policy in place. This topic has been a very polarizing topic between our members. I think it was handled terribly by GM. Don't get me wrong, I do think the vaccination policy is a correct plan, but there could have been other options that they used. Likely the biggest slap in the face is that GM is failing to implement this in the USA. 50,000 members there, they dwarf us in comparison by numbers, yet they're comfortable running their facilities in the US with no requirements to vaccinate. It's a true double standard. There is a big difference between people who are vaccine hesitant and those who are just anti-vax and don't want to do it no matter what. If you're not going to get vaccinated, have no religious or medical exemption, and just have no thoughts whatsoever on taking anything alternative, and it's just going to be a flat no, they are likely going to terminate you at some point, probably in January. We will grieve each termination. We're going to try and talk to you to see if you want to change your mind, but I want to be very, very, very clear. We just look at the case law that is piling up. You have a very weak case to get your case overturned. We are doing our jobs, and right now it appears that well over 99% of our members will continue to work on Monday with no issues. So I believe we're getting there. We just need these people, the last 100 or so people, to call Jackie, straighten it out, and hopefully it's smooth sailing on Monday for 99.9% of the people. Okay, I'd now like to continue with the bright drop. The first saleable vehicles are starting to be processed through CAMI at the TFT dock. That's fantastic news. The trades have been instrumental in setting up the TFT facility. They help turn basically a warehouse into a functioning manufacturing cell. Plus, they also help run 6,000 cables of fiber optics from TFT underground and over the mezzanine in the plant, which was a huge undertaking. The launch team has also done an excellent job keeping the builds on schedule. They continue to learn a lot each day. We have a lot of work ahead of us, but we are definitely heading into exciting times. Also, the launch team this week has started the full end line of processing at TFT. They are now doing the Waha, DVT, Care, Squeak Rattle, GSA, and the shower leak are all being performed this week at TFT by our launch team. Bright drop postings. The union and company have come to an official agreement regarding the bright drop staffing. We are going to try and post the guidelines that I'm going to say next on our site by this afternoon, but likely by tomorrow, so that you can see exactly what jobs are being grandfathered instead of having to try and remember it. So it'll be on our website so everyone can follow the rules as well. Here are the main details. Everyone will have their posting rights returned for all bright drop postings. All the jobs will be plant-wide postings. A few jobs will be grandfathered, but there are very few. We are given a list of jobs based on skill and ability. We argued anyone can be trained, so the list was greatly reduced. We still agree that they need to protect certain jobs to help protect the launch of the new truck. That is why we agreed to a certain number of grandfathering positions. Here is the list. And remember, we're going to try and post this tomorrow so everyone can remember what's going on. Our original core team jobs will be kept. In QC, the task force, straight days, and the torque team. On materials, throughout the whole plant, only one job, the count team leader, will be the only job grandfathered. In paint, only one team, e-coat team on A and B shift. In body shop, again, just one team, it'll be the dig team on A and B shift. And in assembly, it's assembly repair team. However, the A shift and B shift team leaders, as well as the top four PAs. So there'll be two PAs on a shift. Everything after that will be posted. That gives a mix of skill and ability on repair, but also will open up the floor so people can post their repair. And also the final job, one job, the Kaizen job in assembly will be grandfathered. So that's about it. It's about 20 jobs out of well over 1,000 or 1,200. So I think we did very good that way. So if you're reading between the lines, if you're currently on the Bright Drop launch team or the KUKA team, your jobs are going to be reduced sometime over the next few months, and those members should also be looking at the posting boards. Some of the jobs are going to be posted soon, potentially next week. We want people to realize that. Some of the jobs that we agreed that that will be posted require a great deal of training. Tire sub team leaders, for instance, is one. Audit job would be one. Potentially the operators in paint. These jobs may go up by next week already. When you see the post, read the post carefully. You will see some of the postings may be Equinox only, which just means the job might go up and it'll be gone by April. But some of the jobs are going to say Equinox / Bright Drop. They're going to be up on a different colored piece of paper. They're going to be clearly identified on the website. But these jobs you will go to immediately, likely in January, and you will stay there, and that's the job you'll be considered to be on the launch or for the Bright Drop. We do not have a timeline yet for all the jobs, nor do we know how all the departments or teams are going to be set up. So we do have a few months of work yet to try and get the team set up on what it's going to look like. We are going to look at posting the vast majority of the Bright Drops, likely when most people are laid off, like the entire plant. Likely the team leader jobs will get posted first and hopefully while you're at work. Then we're going to post the departments in a specific order picked by the union, so that you don't have to watch the posting board the whole time you're off. So for instance, we're going to post, for an example only, let's say we're done April 22nd, maybe May 1st we will post all the assembly or all the QC jobs. So everybody can post all the QC areas if they want. We'll leave the jobs up for example 2 weeks, and then for 2 weeks they'll show the confirmations, and June 1st we'll show them. Then we'll do materials. And every month we'll do a different department, and then we'll work our way down to assembly, which will be the final jobs. If you don't post at the end of the process, if you have the scenario, you're going to bump the junior people, likely in assembly, and then we'll have an SG group on top of that. In the last week of December, the company is working on a plan right now to bring every single person in the plant to the assembly pilot area so that everyone will have the opportunity to see and touch our new Bright Drop truck. There will be one in the pilot area. The past 2 years due to COVID and parts issues have been very tough on us. 2022 hopefully will bring us 4 months of steady production, then an entire rebirth of our plant as we transform into Canada's first wholly electric vehicle assembly plant. At some point in the fall of 2022, our next chapter will begin that looks extremely promising as each of us will help lead Canada into the future. On behalf of our entire implant committee, we would like to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas and a happy and more importantly, healthy New Year. See you next year.